Welcome back. Myself, Anita Halder, welcomes you. Let's talk about and know more about chemical bonding, how these bond theory came into existence. Valence bond theory talks about that is how a covalent bond is formed by overlapping of valence shell atomic orbital of the two atoms leaving unpaired electrons. There is maximum electron density between the bonding atoms. Greater the overlapping of atomic orbital, I repeat, greater the overlapping of atomic orbital, higher is the strength of chemical bond. The bond formed bilateral overlap. I hope you all know what is the lateral site. Lateral overlap of two atomic orbitals having maximum overlapping on both sides of the line connecting the center of the atom is called a pi bond. A pi bond possesses a plane of symmetry often referred to as an ideal plane. Here you can check the lateral overlap example is given. Right, that is, we can say this pi bond is having side-to-side overlap, which is known as lateral side, and here we have head-to-head overlap for the sigma bond. Now, bond which has sigma bond is a strong bond, whereas pi bond is a weak bond because the pi bond is formed by sharing of electrons from the p orbitals with the weak intermolecular force of attractions. We will learn this in detail. Now, what is a sigma bond? A sigma bond is a covalent bond which is formed by overlapping of atomic orbital along the same axis. It is known as sigma bond, or we can also say as S bond, but basically we define it as sigma bond. Such type of bond is symmetrical about the line joining the two nuclei. Here you can see sigma bond can be SS overlapping, SP overlapping and PP overlapping as well. But it is always the overlapping is done at the same axis and head to head overlapping. No side overlapping takes place in sigma bond. Though the PP overlapping is taking place, again it is on the same axis and the head to head overlapping is being taken place. So sigma bond can be formed by SS orbital, overlapping of SS orbital. Now when they these orbital overlaps, when they have almost minimum difference in their energy, so they are able to overlap and they give rise to a molecule. You can see here S orbital and P orbital. P orbital are dumbbell shape, whereas S orbital are the spherical in shape and PP overlapping. Now a pi bond. Pi bond is a bond which is formed by the sidewise or lateral overlapping. Right, as we have discussed earlier as well, that pi bond means it is a sidewise overlap or a lateral overlapping. So sidewise or lateral overlapping, they mean the same, and overlapping of two half filled atomic orbitals takes place. So you can see how the pi bonds are formed above and below the plane. Right, why above and below the plane? Because this is a p orbital, right? Where p orbital means y and right, p orbital, py, we have talked about, px, we have talked about, right? So px and py orbital are involved in the pi bond formation. The strength of the bond depends upon the extent of overlapping of half-filled atomic orbitals. If the extent of overlapping is between two atoms, is always greater, extent of overlapping between two atoms is always greater when there is end-to-end overlapping, then the sidewise. So end-to-end overlapping takes place and forms sigma bond, whereas side-to-side overlapping takes place and it gives rise to pi bond. So we can say sigma bond is always stronger than the pi bond. Sigma bond is always stronger than the pi bond or p bond when we are talking about that. We can even call these as sigma bond as s bond or p bond as pi bond. Sigma, and this is our pi bond. Next, how hybridization takes place. Now, what is hybridization? Hybridization means the mixing of dissimilar, orbital. That means the mixing of different orbitals of similar energy to form new set of hybrid orbital. Number of hybrid orbital formed is equal to the number of orbital taking part in hybridization. Depending upon the different combination of s and p orbitals, these type of hybridizations are well known as sp3, sp2, sp. So when we are talking about sp3 hybridizations, at that moment one s orbital and three p orbitals are participating in the bond formation, which results into the sp3 hybridization. As for your previous year studies, if you can recall that methane is an example of sp3 hybridization. Here in the given picture, methane structure is explained, whereas on the left hand side you can see, on your left hand side here, the ethane, right, CH3 bond CH3 is getting hybridized and ethane molecule is formed. Here this is carbon atom with its p orbital, and you can see how carbon and carbon atom is, right, carbon s orbital and another s orbital of carbon atom, how they are participating in the bond formation, and how s orbital of hydrogen atom and p orbital of the carbon atom is participating in the bond formation, and they result into sp3 hybridization, right. Next, we are talking about the sp2 hybridization. Sp2 hybridization means a compound having one single bond and one pi bond, that is one sigma bond and one pi bond, means a compound must possess at least one double bond. For example, ethene, they are forming a pi bond, right, above and below the plane, and we have seen how this is a p orbital, right, the p orbital with the weak intermolecular force of attraction, then they overlap by the sidewise overlap takes place and they result into a pi bond, give rise to CH2, double bond CH2. Now, in case of compound possessing sp2 hybridization, they have trigonal planar geometry. I repeat, sp2 hybridization containing compounds have trigonal planar geometry. Next, talking about sp hybridization, in this case, one s orbital and three p orbitals, p orbital, right, one p orbital is taken place. You can see here green color, right, you can also see over here as well that how many p orbital is participating in sp2. So two p orbitals, right, green color, this p orbital is there, and one unchanged p orbital. So this p orbital is participating in the bond formation. Similarly here as well, only sp means one s and one p orbital participate in the bond formation, which results into, right, sp hybridization. That is, you can see here, okay, they are participating in the bond formation. So the remaining two unhybridized p orbital overlap. Here we have two unhybridized p orbital which overlap with one another and lead to the formation of two pi bonds. Right. So here as well, one unchanged orbital which participates in the formation of the pi bond. You can see only one p orbital is participating in the pi bond. Here two p orbitals are participating in the pi bond formation. So here we go with these hybridizations, that is total number of orbitals taking part and its shape. So we have these various kinds of hybridization. Now sp3d and sp3d2, even d2sp3, these all various types of hybridizations you are going to learn in detail in grade 12, right? And sp3d, this you are going to learn in this chapter as well, as we have learned about pcl5, which do not obey the central atom, do not obey octet rule, and yet it is a stable compound. It is having a trigonal bipyramidal shape, which causes sp3d hybridization. And in sp3d2, we have the octahedral shape of the molecule, that is sf6. And for sp hybridizations, we have two variations. Either it can be tetrahedral or it can also be a square plane. So those other exceptional structures we will be learning later on in grade 12. Now bond characteristics, how the bond is formed, we have already learned, that is there are three different types of bond: ionic bond, covalent bond and coordinate bond. Now when a bond is formed, definitely its characteristics, the strength of the bond present in a given molecule is measured, right? So how they are related to each other, that is by bond length. Now what is bond length? The distance between the nuclei of two atoms bonded together is called bond length. It is expressed in angstrom unit or picometer, that is pm. Bond length in ionic compound is equals to rc plus, that is cation, plus anion. Radius of cation plus radius of anion will give you the bond length in ionic compound, whereas bond length in covalent compound is measured between RA radius of atom B, A plus radius of atom B, that is compound AB, gives you the bond length in ionic compound as well as covalent compound. Thank you. Have a nice day. Please refer the topic, revise it, stay safe, stay healthy.